wellness platform, Ravi, and we're so happy to have you on board. And I've known you for so many years. And on behalf of Playscape, ProCam International, Airtel, Half Delhi Marathon, and of course the Knowledge Hub, I'm sure we're going to gain a lot of knowledge for you from you the next half an hour. And everybody, Ravi Dixit is the pioneer of yoga and one of the pioneers in India, and he is the founder, and he's his mama is the yogi who started the famous Kevalya Dham yoga center in Marine Drive, which is very famous. It needs no introduction. And Ravi, tell us something about yoga, your views on yoga.
Well, first of all, thank you, Gautam, for inviting me, and it's really a pleasure to share whatever I have learned and gained, and you know, whatever I know. Before we go ahead, I want to ask you, how many hearts you have?
How many hearts?
Hearts. Kitne dil hai?
How many hearts do I have? I don't know. Okay. I hope I have more than one, but unfortunately, I don't.
All right. So, guess.
How many do I have? You tell me.
Okay. Anatomically, yes, we all have one. But we have many, we give it to many, and like that's a different way of saying it. You have people you love, you friendship and family and all that. So heart goes to everybody. But logically, since we're talking about the marathon and running and all that, we have three hearts. Okay. One heart, yes, this one heart, it's pumping the blood to the whole body, right? We need two more hearts to support it. These are calf muscles shaped like this. Calf muscles. So what this heart is doing, pumping blood to the whole body, and these two calf muscles down in your legs, shaped like this, they pump blood back to the body. So this flow keeps you going, keeps you healthy, keeps you really in good shape. So the logic is this way that, you know, water of river, which is flowing, we can drink. It has less toxins and problems and all that. But the water which gets stagnated has a lot of, you know, insects and toxins and problems. You can't. Like in a pond and all that. So same logic is here. If the flow of your energy, blood circulation is happening properly, means your heart, real heart on the left side here, and those two calf muscles are functioning well and quite healthy, you will have no problem. Energy will be fine, body will be healthy. So that's why I thought I must talk about this three heart concept. So
this is a very interesting concept, I must say.
Exactly. So unless we keep our those two heart, calf muscles strong and healthy, you can't run. Yes. Forget about running. You can't even have good flow of energy. Can't have good, you know, blood oxygen going everywhere else. So therefore, the sync of these three heart is very important. And therefore, we need yoga and proper scientific way of understanding, learning, and doing things.
So what you're saying is, since we are right now on a very interesting platform, it's for the marathoners.
Yes.
So a marathoner or anyone even who's a novice runner, you need to have yoga is very beneficial for even marathoners and different athletes. That's what you're saying. So
yes,
it's all about the breath. Am I right? I mean, it's the way you conserve
Correct.
Your breath, or the way you inhale, the way you exhale when you run, because it's very tedious.
Correct.
And, so can you tell us, give us some insight into how a runner has to prepare himself, and what are the yoga asanas he may have to do to enhance his performance?
All right, Gautam. We all know yoga is a wonderful science of health and healing. Now, the worldwide, it is famous. Our Prime Minister has done a great job. UN has sanctioned it 21st June Yoga Day. So now, worldwide, yoga is famous. It's a wealth of India now. The whole world is enjoying it, right? So let me tell you in short, basically there are two kinds of yoga people do, asanas mainly, as the static and dynamic. Okay, so when you do static program, static asanas, you are much more benefited, much more at ease and relaxed. The minute you go into dynamic, you have more exertion and more tiredness, more fatigue and all that. Something similar happens to the runners. They are so much physically exhausted and tired and all that, body produces, muscle produce more lactic acid. Now, how to not get tired? How to minimize, or body should be able to use that lactic acid and throw it out, so we are not tired, we are not exhausted. So therefore, static way of running. Yoga has static way, but how we can have a, not exactly like static, but how to run in a way where you relax, using your body rhythm and breath rhythm perfectly, which is important mind as well. So how to sync your mind, emotion, body and breath? How to not get either physically tired or mentally or emotionally, or the breath, which is you sometimes got, you know, breathless. So there are various ways. We have been training many, we have been guiding many. But I can tell you in short, one simple funda is practice, practice, and practice. There is no shortcut to that. Okay.
Absolutely.
There is no shortcut to practice. Yeah. So, and in short, I would say yoga basically can be also summed up in a triple D: discipline, determination, and devotion. So whether you are a yoga practitioner or businessman or whatever you do, have triple D: discipline, determination, and devotion. Success will be there. I was saying, very interesting, I was saying this in the US. So those students told me, Ravi, you are missing out the fourth D. 3D I mentioned: discipline, determination, devotion. He said, no, fourth D is very important. So which is the fourth one? Can you guess, Gautam? I was talking to US students in US. They said, discipline, determination, devotion, I said. They said, no, one more important, the fourth one. And I'll give you the clue. This is in US. US were keen to say and remind me, Ravi, fourth D is also important.
I hope you're nothing to do with Mr. Donald.
No, not really, but yes, I will, you know, it's about dollar, it's about money. So yeah, when you have triple D, discipline, determination, and fourth D follows, the money or the wealth follow you, right? Yeah. But good one, you mentioned that. So my point was, if you have triple D, whether it's running or business, you will have that. So in short, fourth D will follow you the minute you have triple D, whether it's a wealth or health or running. Anything you do, you will have success. Okay, now the few tips I want to give you.
Please.
For runners, basically. As I said, three heart. The calf muscles are very, very important to be healthy. Your joints and all that, beside your breath, mind, emotions, and the body. So what we should do, there are certain asanas, simple asanas, like, Utkatasana is there, Sarvangasana is there, Halasana, Bhavan Muktasana, and various more asanas, which I can, give you a list later on. And what one should do about the breath? See, normally what mistake we do, let me test you, okay, if you don't mind it. Okay, you can edit this later on maybe.
Let me
see how you breathe. Just take a deep breath. Since you are into the fitness, you are fairly right, but not very right to breathe. Now, what mistake we all do, when we say take a deep breath, I'll just zoom in. We do this way, we fill up the upper body.
Yes.
That's wrong. Your lower lobe, your lower lungs are not being expanded. Yes. Diaphragm is closing them. So if you breathe in only in the upper body, like I'm not using my lower lungs, lower lobe, my diaphragm closes them. So don't ever do this, like fill up your body.
I thought you wanted me to do a deep breath.
No, understood. But, So breath is very important. If you breathe in, chest goes slightly up, forward, and even downward. So it's all around. The trunk is filled up properly. So it's like a room. It's like a balloon. You're filling it up all the sides, not upward only. The minute we take it upward, that means we are not using our lungs to the maximum. So remember, for my runner friends or whoever is into the health, please breathe well. Breathing should be slow, deep, and long. The minute you breathe slow, deep, and long, using the whole trunk, forward, front, and downward as well. Even the sides are expanded. Even the back is expanded. So the trunk is used like a balloon. Every corner to corner, we breathe and you have a good breath, deep inhalation, right? We normally inhale 500 ml air. But when you breathe correctly like this, you can breathe 6 times more. Imagine you breathe 2,500, 3,000 ml air. So much oxygen you already have taken. So body can use maximum. So very important point is to breathe well, correctly. Use the whole trunk like a balloon, like a room. Fill it up, down, sides, back and front, everywhere. Without being tired, not to using the exertion force to Not forcing like this.
It should just be fluid. It should be fluid. That's
yeah, smooth, rhythmic, slow, deep and long. Effortless, but slow, deep and long. One area I have mentioned, the inhalation part, very important. Yes. But the more important is exhalation part. The reason is because you have taken the air inside already. Now your body has used it. So body has to ensure that used air is thrown out completely. And when used air is thrown out completely, you are doing detox.
Detoxifying yourself.
You're also, exactly. So unless you breathe out completely, body has no place to take fresh air in. So inhalation is important, but exhalation is more important. So now how to exhale? Let the chest come down, diaphragm shrink a bit, and tummy gently goes in. So you empty completely. So very important point is to inhale fully, deeply, slowly, long. Exhale completely, slowly, and empty your whole trunk, diaphragm, and the chest, and the tummy as well. So that is important. Now, if people can breathe well, exhale out correctly, inhale properly, they will have more energy, more breath to use, and less tiredness. Mm. So this is important to breathe correctly. Okay. As I said, we are breathing 500 ml air, but we can breathe 5 to 6 times more. And imagine if you breathe that much, you will have more energy, more strength, and more oxygen for the body to use, you know.
So breath control is a very, very vital part of our existence, our day-to-day existence. Ooh, I mean, everything is, there's so many things connected to breath, even your mindset, your mood, your, of course, your energy levels, you can be a great athlete. Like you correctly mentioned, you won't get tired so easily. Plus, yes. You'll be calmer. You'll be calmer. And,
yes. Yes. A few more tips I want to give you. Example with example. You know, lifespan of rat, mouse, chuha is around 100 years or so. And how many times he breathes? Guess?
I have no idea.
I have mentioned it other way around. He lives around 2-3 years, but breathes around 100 times in a minute. Okay? So rat, mouse, chuha is breathing. Yeah, breathing around 100 or so in a minute, but lives for 2-3 years. Whereas the tortoise, kachua, you know, turtle, he breathes only in 4 minutes only one, lives for 2-300 years. Yeah. And we human breathe around 16 times in a minute and live average 65-70 years. Yes. So the logic is slower the breath rate, longer the lifespan.
Yes.
The example is, kachua, tortoise, turtle, mouse, rat. The mouse, rat breathes very fast. Lifespan is very short. Kachua, tortoise, turtle breathes very slow. Lifespan is longer. We humans, we breathe 16 times a minute and have average 65 years of age. Now, how to improve this?
That's why dogs live only 12 or 15 because they breathe much faster.
Yes. So, therefore, we have pranayama. We have meditation. Suppose this pranayama we do, I inhale from here for 8-10 seconds. I breathe out from here for 15-20 seconds, so nearly 30 seconds. Again, I inhale from here 8-10 seconds and out for 20 seconds. So basically, I am doing two circles, two rounds in 1 minute. So if you do pranayama like this more often for a few minutes and all that regularly, you are slowing down your breath rate. Slower the breath rate, longer for lifespan. Body is using less energy. Body is more relaxed. Same with the meditation. When you meditate, your breath becomes very silent, maybe 2 or 3 or so. So you are basically creating more energy, saving more energy, and getting completely refreshed. See, when we meditate, when we relax or when we sleep, the total rejuvenation or repair healing happens when you're sleeping or meditating. We have seen in our labs in Cavillingham, 10 minutes of Shavasana or meditation is equal to 2 hours of sound sleep. So the process of silencing your breath is very important. And now what happens when your breath is silent or slow or silent and gentle, like yogic breath, you have your parasympathetic system more active. And when parasympathetic system is more active, you have body is doing more healing, more repair, more rejuvenation, and more freshness. So the breath workout is very important. So any runner must practice yoga, whether before or at the end. And then once he does yoga every day, he or she will pick up how to use yogic techniques during running, while running. So wonderful. Breath workout, meditations, all are scientific.
And how do you avoid?
So I mentioned about. Yeah.
No, sorry. Please continue. I think that was a hitch.
I missed out your question. No, I missed out a question. What was saying?
I wanted to ask you about how do you avoid or minimize injury if you're a sportsman? I mean,
okay.
You know, especially when you're runners or you're even a novice athlete, amateur athlete. I mean, anyone who plays a sport, if you're playing squash, you could be walking in your building, but you're always susceptible to some kind of, you know, injury. How does, what's the best way? Is it only through the movement of your, you tell us.
Okay. There are two, three ways one can minimize the injuries.
Yes.
One is, again, breath is very important. Lactic acid should be reduced in the body.
Correct.
If lactic acid is less, and the muscle tone, muscle flexibility, elasticity is very important. If muscles are flexible by doing static workout of yoga, static way of yoga, your muscles will be stronger and will not get torn out. Joints is a different thing anyway. So static workout is very important. Minimize the lactic acid by proper breath workout. And obviously, one point no one can deny it, that you need to have properly warm up. You need to have some regular, you know, loosening. Hydrate yourself. People miss out on proper liquids, fluids. So if you hydrate yourself properly, balancing your salt and sugar in the body, you will have less injuries. So ensure that you drink properly. Yeah. So food is very important. Vitamins are important. Plus the breath workout, static way of yoga. Static workout is important. So there are isotonic, isometric workout. So the minute you do yogic way of workout, your muscles are stronger and better. And they're more suppleness. So any sudden movements, any sudden stretching, they can handle it. They can take it. You know, your joints, ligaments, and all that are very much prepared for it. So static workout in your routine is very important. Dynamic is also required for runner. Obviously, they have to have dynamic workout, but static is important to balance it and ensure the injuries are reduced by keeping the muscle stronger and flexible.
So your skeletal
with less lactic acid.
Has got to be strengthened. The skeletal muscle tissue is of prime importance.
Yes.
And this can be greatly achieved by doing the right asanas and, like you said, breath control and nutrition. And there's so many aspects that go into making the body.
Yes.
I was talking to a very interesting gentleman the other day. He's a Colonel Abhishek Chaturvedi. Actually, he's on the same show. And he is the head of the Elite Commando Force of India. He's a very old friend of mine. He was telling us about the tough training the commandos have. So what you're saying is so true. I mean, he even said, he told me, he didn't tell me on the call, but he said they meditate. They run like 40 kilometers with 17 kgs of sand in a bag they're holding behind. And they have to complete that in 5 hours. So
great.
Commando. I mean, so they are runners, cross-country running. And so, you know, it's so good what you're saying, because everything is about strengthening your bones. And if you don't have strong bones and you don't have muscles that supporting the bones or the bones supporting the muscles, then
you're
in for trouble.
Yes. Correct. Yes.
That's good.
Yeah.
So what about back pain, Ravi? Nowadays, a lot of people have a lot of chronic back pain, and they have what really concerns me is a lot of people have arthritis and rheumatoid arthritis, back pain. You think yoga, I mean, of course, yoga helps, but are there specific asanas that you recommend? There are a lot of asanas for back.
See, mainly, we should also understand. Can you hear me?
Very well.
Okay. Mainly, we should understand why back pain. Why back pain is very important. If you remove the why, you will not get back pain. That is also important, isn't it? So, ensure you don't sit for a long time. Every half an hour or so, you must keep moving.
Yes.
As I was talking about flow of energy in the body. If the flow of energy is proper, you will have less pain, aches, and problem. All the pains and aches and problems in the body are due to the stagnation of the energy in the body. We sit down for more than half an hour, stagnation happens, especially in the low back area, or maybe feet. Like we are now using computer like this for a long time. Stagnation of energy happens here. And we are stressed also. So generally, energy flow is important. And simple logic that you must move around every half an hour. End of nerves, your fingers and toes are very important to keep active.
Yes.
Because if fingers are toes, yes. You know, making this twist and moving the toes or feet. Exactly. So fingers and toes, if they move, energy flows. Your body has a good flow of energy.
Absolutely.
So these are the general basic points. But asana-wise, I will tell you, simple asanas like Ardha Padmuktasana, pelvic lift, pelvic twist, and Pavan Muktasana. These five asanas beside Bhujangasana and Shalvasana. 8 to 10 asanas correctly is very important. Generally, people have problem with doing correct asanas. See, same posture can harm you, same can give you benefit.
Yes.
If you do it correctly. That's why you need teacher, you need someone to guide you properly. So proper posture will help you. Name-wise, Pavan Muktasana, Setu Bandhasana, Kati Vakrasana, Bhujangasana, Shalbhasana, Makrasana, and Shavasana. Yes. Often keeping legs folded while being flat on the floor is important. Generally, straight legs while sleeping are not so good for the back. So put some pillow behind your legs while they're slightly folded or sleep sideways. Ideally, don't sit for a long time. That is something simple, very
don't
simple.
Don't be sedentary. Keep moving.
Yes, the simple body, when see pain is the initial stage of a problem. Pain means body is telling you your energy is not flowing right in the body.
Correct.
Pain is a simple body's cry. Body is making noise. Body saying, come on, get a move. Pain is this initial sign. People ignore it.
Talks to you. Listen to your body.
Yes. People ignore it. And that pain causes further damage. And then it's too late to control, you know, and go to the hospital and take medicine. So, mental scanning of spine.
Correct.
Emotional x-ray of spine is very important, which happens in Shavasana. When you lie down or do asanas. So, scan your spine, x-ray spine while doing asanas or in Shavasana. So, you will not go to the hospital to do the scanning of the spine or the x-ray of the spine.
Absolutely. There has to be a mind-body connect.
True.
And prevention, as they say, is always better than cure. So, I've realized one thing. People take this very lightly, exactly what you're saying. These are such simple things we can do to boost our... You know, to live a very productive life, especially as we grow older. But people will wait for the pains to come in and then they'll start popping pills, painkillers, and then they end up in the hospital and then one thing leads to another. But if they just have a little self-love, I think it's, you know, because your body is your biggest wealth. If your health is your biggest wealth. And it's more than the dollars, as they say. If you don't have health, you can't enjoy the dollars.
Yes. True.
Kya kar sakte?
Yes. Yeah.
I'm looking forward to doing master classes with you.
And, okay.
What we discussed the other day, and you know, because this is something, yoga is something that is now. Of course, thanks to India, we are all over the world. I mean, the European community, we have Yoga Day in Rishikesh. We have that whole fantastic festival. A dear friend of mine shoots the entire festival. He's a filmmaker and he tells me about it. And then we have yoga in America. We have yoga in Europe. We have yoga everywhere. Yeah. And thanks to our great yogis, it's fabulous. But Ravi, I wanted to ask you a very funny question. I mean, I don't know if it's funny. But nowadays, you have pet yoga, you have hot yoga, you have this yoga, you have that yoga. Do you think this is taking away from the essence of the real yoga? Because honestly, I find it a little funny. I mean, with due respect to all the people doing it, but I feel it's... I mean, what are your views on this? Because you are the real yogi. I mean, you're the man who, you know, who walks the talk. So what are your views?
Basically, human nature is that they get bored of the same thing. They have less patience and all that. So they come up with something new.
Yeah.
New yoga style, new posture, new this, human nature. But
yes,
the traditional yoga will always be there.
Yeah.
Now, all over the world have classes, courses through Kevalanam. People are into traditional yoga. Of this, you know, all those funny names, dog yoga, various all kinds of yoga. So people are fed up. They do it for a sake of just trying it out. It's like a soda, you know. You open it, it just goes up and then finishes completely.
Right.
It's not a water H2O which is always there. So traditional yoga is yes.
I love the metaphor.
So traditional yoga will always be there. People will try things here and there. My only concern is sometimes for fun trying is different, but people should not stick to those untraditional things. Something which is based on tradition and science is safe. And now we have done research, we follow the books, and that's why you have individual expert doctors, teachers nowadays. And let me tell you also, our Swamiji, first ever research magazine was published. Research was done in Kevalanam in 1924.
I see.
No one had about the scientific aspect of yoga. Yes, we have the books and magazines. 1924, first ever magazine called Yoga Mimamsa was published by Swamiji in Lonavala, Kevalanam. And that was the first ever research in yoga. And then from 40-50 onward, people have taken up more. But till 40-50, nobody had any clue. So we are pioneer in research. We are following traditional, and we are doing something which is safe, scientific, and you know, more of therapeutic as well.
Fantastic, Ravi. This is I just hope more and more people follow your kind of lifestyle. I'm going to start very soon. I'm going to start coming to Kevalanam and meeting you.
Please.
You're bubbling with positive energy and you're always smiling ever since I've known you. And I know it's because of your breath and your yoga and your discipline and your...
Yes. I'll give you one more clue. One more clue. Use body in a balanced manner. Why I don't get tired? I use my body equally. If I do something with the left hand, I will do with the right hand also.
Yes.
If I look left, I will look right as well. So if you use your body in a balanced manner, you don't get tired.
Correct. So these are these small
and
tips.
Mostly the tiredness is here.
Yeah. The fatigue comes from here.
Yes.
Mind body connection.
See, if the runner is running only here,
correct,
and stressing out, then it's a, you know, body is more tired. So he should just forget that. And, yeah.
Correct. Ravi, thank
run
you so
with
much.
The meditation.
No, absolutely. It's
okay. Last words.
Please.
Last word.
Yes.
Meditate while running.
Oh, yes.
Run in a meditative way.
Be a meditative marathon.
Yeah.
Be a meditative marathon.
Yes.
Ravi, thank you so much for coming on board. It's been a fabulous, insightful talk with you. And I hope to get you on more often. I know you're a very busy man. But
I have just drove Mumbai and after driving, I am talking to you.
You've driven from where, you said?
From Mumbai to Pune.
And then
I'm here with you.
Oh, wonderful. See, you're not tired.
No.
You're fresh. You're absolutely fresh. So thank you, Ravi. And look forward to talking to you again and being part of your master classes with the Be Conscious platform. And we'll speak to you soon, and I'm sure a lot of people are going to get some very precious knowledge with your talk today.
Thank you so much, Gautam. And I just want to say that please do yoga, which is traditional, scientific, and do every day.
Jesus.
Correctly and practice yoga correctly. Thank you.
Thank you, Ravi. Thank you.
Bye-bye.